Shuklambaradharam Vishnum Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasannavadanam Dhyayet Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedhase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha. Dear friends, we are seeing Valmiki Ramayana. We are in this Aranyakanda, Sarga number 56, where Ravana initially thought he was a Kurtakrutya. He congratulated himself, "I have done what has to be done and I have accomplished my task." He took Sita around and then he showed his palace, which was all glittering with gold, and everywhere there were golds, jewels, gems and what not. All that thing did not impress Sita. So this Ravana also said, "There is nobody who is equal to me in all the three worlds. No Deva, Gandharva, Kinnara, etc. Nobody who is equal to me, etc." Sita was not impressed, and all that glitter of gold did not attract her, because she has once been cheated by the golden deer. So this gold, again, it is an important metaphor. If we see in Ramayana, gold is a sort of metaphor, starting from that golden deer. So that Sita sees that golden deer and she gets temporarily attracted by that. That is the Jivatma or Jiva getting attracted by the sensual pleasures and getting bound by the mind. And once getting bound by the mind, but this in the case of Sita, she is also aware of this bondage and she also wants to get rid of the bondage. She wants to get out of that bondage. So all the glitter of that gold and all the wealth which was shown by Ravana, it did not impress. And in fact, here, the mind is compared to be a golden bowl. Upanishads, actually, they compare the mind to a golden bowl. And this golden bowl, it presents so many attractive things to the Jiva. It tries to bind the Jivatma, and the Jivatma is temporarily identifying itself with the body-mind complex and it is enjoying all the pleasures. So that is the reason why the mind is said to be the greatest obstacle in the path of realization. So a person who wants realization or Atmajnana or what is called self-realization, he has to conquer the mind, he has to subdue the mind first. So the mind itself is the tool and mind itself is the block. So that is the paradoxical situation. The paradoxical situation which is described in Vedanta is that the mind, manayeva manushyanam karanam bandha mokshayoho deshe. The mind itself is the karanam for bandha. Bandha means bondage, and it is also the karanam, the cause for liberation. Because once you subdue the mind, then the mind itself is your servant. Otherwise, the mind is your master. So the one Upanishad says, Hiranmayena patrena satyasyapi hitam mukham, says one Ishavasya Upanishad. Hiranmayena patrena, this mind is compared to a golden bowl, which is actually hiding. Satyasya apihitam mukham, it is hiding the truth, it is hiding the reality, it is hiding Paramatma. So the Jivatma is getting attracted by all this golden, the glitter of gold, and she is getting far away, she is getting removed, Jivatma is getting removed from Paramatma. So that is a broad metaphor, gold as a metaphor, which we see in Ramayana. If you see as a student of literature, if you see, look at it as a student of literature, leaving aside all other symbolism and religious symbolism and all that, this gold, it can be seen, this gold is seen as a metaphor. So anyway, here Ravana was telling all these pishachis, when he realized that Sita was not going to yield, he became very furious. He called all these very fierce looking female demoness, this female demons or rather demonesses, okay. And she tells them, now you have to break her will. So he was using the word called darpamasya apaneshyantu. So her will, her darpa, her arrogance and all that, you have to subdue that arrogance. And now he is also giving a strategy. Take her to that isolated place called Ashokavana, and in that place very secretly you tatrayam rakshyatam gudham. Gudham means very secretly you keep her, and then you have to interrogate her. How to interrogate? Ravana is telling how to interrogate. Tatrayanam tarjanair ghoraihi punas santvaischa maithilim. First tarjanaihi, tarjana means threatening. We know that this finger is called tarjani. This is what is called angushta or anguta in Hindi. Tarjani, this every all the five fingers have got names in Sanskrit. I don't know whether we have it in English or not, but in Sanskrit this is called Angustha, this is called Tarjani. Tarjani means, Tarjana is threatening a person. So, when you are threatening a person, invariably we are using this finger. So, that is the reason why it is called Tarjani. So, this Tarjani. So, Tarjanaihi and Tarjanair Ghoraihi, in very, very serious threats, very serious threats and very serious fearful threats, and then Punaha Santvaishya, and again Santvaihya, that is again gently. First blow hot, blow cold, this is what is called blow hot, blow cold. There is also a technical term in armed forces, they call it the good cop, bad cop. First it is the bad cop who comes and then who puts a lot of pressure, who says I am going to break you. Sometimes they also use physical violence, so they just use all physical violence, they try to torture and all that. And meanwhile, one fellow acting as a good cop, he comes and then, no, let us wait, let us, don't be in a hurry. We will be gentle, let us adopt a gentle approach. And again this bad cop goes and the good cop tries to, so he gives some food, maybe he will give a cigarette, he will give some biscuits, he will give some nice coffee, and then he will try to befriend. So one fellow is threatening, I am just going to kill you, I am just going to put a bullet right now, and he threatens. The other fellow comes slowly and then he says no, he comes and then adopts a gentle way. So this is a sort of interrogation technique actually, it is a sort of interrogation technique, a good cop, bad cop, we also see it in some of these English movies, when the hero usually is under interrogation by this team. So this is a sort of, this is what Ravana also knows, and naturally Valmiki also knows, so that is why he is writing. Tatrainam tarjanaihi ghoraihi punaha, punaha means once that threat is there, thereafter santvaishya punaha santvaishya maithilim anayadvam vasham sarvaha. You have to now bring her under control, so that is what, so he says. And iti pratisamadishta rakshasyo rakshanenatah, then they are all very clear about their mission, they are very happy. If they are asked to behave gently with Sita, there is a problem. If they are asked to behave in a very, very ruthless manner, it is very comfortable for them, because it is their own natural, it is their own nature, so they can be very easily be ruthless. So they all grab her and then take her to Ashokavana, and that Ashokavana is a very brief description. Sarva kama phalaihi vrukshaihi, that is a tree, that is a vanam where all fruit bearing trees are there, and fruit bearing trees which give fruits all round the year, etc. And in that Ashokavana, surrounded by all these rakshasis, all these pishachis, she was looking like a deer in the midst of all tigresses. Rakshasi vashamapanna Vyagrinam Harini Yatha. Harini is a female deer, and that deer in the midst of all these tigresses, she was looking like that, and she was just wailing, Patim Smaranti Daitam Cha Devaram Vichetana Bhut Bhaya Shoka Pidita. She was scared, Bhaya Shoka Pidita Vichetana Bhut. Vichetana means she became unconscious, she fell unconscious when this they were administering all types of threats, she became unconscious. So that is what we see here. And the next sarga, we come to Rama, that is 57th sarga. Up to this 56th sarga, we have seen Sita, and we have seen how Ravana was trying to impress on her. When he failed to impress on her, now he has put some interrogation team on her to break her will. So the time gap given is 12 months, and in that 12 months time, if she is not broken, in fact the breaking is again a technical term used by all these armed forces. They say, oh no, he has not yet broken, you have to break him. So that is what they say. So the 12 month time is given for breaking her will, and if it is not possible, he has to eat her for breakfast. So that is the situation. And for some time now, from now we will not see Sita, because right now Rama will come, and then how Rama, his love for Sita, how he wails, how he laments for Sita, all that we will see. And till Sundarakanda, somewhere in the middle of Sundarakanda, we will again see Sita. Till that time, in the whole of Kishkindakanda, we will not see Sita. Anyway, now we come to the 57th sarga, we are now returning to Rama. And where did we leave Rama? We left Rama where he killed that Maricha, and Maricha immediately came back into his shape, because at the time of dying, all the Maya is gone. When the fellow is dying, all the Maya is gone, and he comes to his original shape, that huge figure, and he cried in Ram, imitating Rama's voice, Ha Sita, Ha Lakshmana, if you recall. And after that, Rama, now how Rama is feeling? Rama also is actually guessing. Oh, now he has realized that this is all Rakshasa Maya, because I have deliberately been dragged far away. I have been I have been trapped in a sense. So he is realizing. So he is returning. And while returning, he sees some bad omens, the animals are howling and all that, some howling of jackals and things like that. And so, Marichena tu vijnaya swaram archya mamakam. Now he is realizing this Maricha, this fellow, mamakam swaram, that ashritya, that is, he imitated my tone, he mimicked my voice. And he said, Ha Sita, Lakshmana, etc. And how would Sita have reacted? Sita, she must have felt very, 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 she must have become very tense. She must have developed anxiety. And she could have also sent away Lakshmana. So he also guesses it. And obviously, it is the plan of the Rakshasas. And say here, Rama sees, now when Rama is thinking like that and he is going towards that, then Rama sees Lakshmana. And Lakshmana also was having a very, very sad face. We know that Lakshmana was shouted at by Sita. In fact, Sita used very harsh words. She said, you are an agent of Bharata. You seem to be, say, hand in glove with Bharata. You seem to be a sort of prachanna shatru. You are outwardly looking like a friend, and inwardly you are an enemy to us. You are just waiting for the death of Rama. And if Rama dies, you want to have me as your wife. So, all that, say, in a very rash way, she became, say, emotional, and in that emotion, she lost her cool. So, she uttered all that, and Rama, Lakshmana, a very, very gentleman, so he got very much hurt. He was pained very much. He was pained very much, and he was also angered. And with that pain and anger, he is coming, and his face is actually drooping, and there is no happiness in his face. So, Rama sees that Lakshmana. And the moment he sees Lakshmana with that sad face, he now realizes something has happened. So, he says, why did you come here? Why did you leave her alone? Vihaya Sitam Vijane Vane Rakshasa Sevite. Why did you come here? And now, Sa Jagarhe. Jagarhe means, he did not approve. Something which is censoring. Garhanam means censoring. You have done something bad. Suppose you want to say something to your subordinate. No, you have failed in this. You have done something bad. So, that is how we say. But Rama is more gentle. Even when he is doing that sort of censoring, he is doing in a rather gentle way. How Valmiki is describing, Gruhitvacha karam savyam Lakshmanam Raghunandanaha. He caught the hand of Lakshmana and he drew him near. Gruhitvatu karam savyam. He took his right hand. And with all gentleness, with all gentleness, he spoke harshly. So that is what Valmiki says. Uvacha madhurodarkam idam parusham artavat. Sweet, but say sweet in tone, but harsh in terms of message. So that is it. Madhurodarkam. Madhurodarkam is without giving up that madhura, madhuriyam. Madhuriyam means sweetness. Without giving up that sweetness, but at the same time being harsh. So, Rama, so even in his great, moment of anxiety, he is still following that etiquette. Even in his great, now we know that Rama is highly disturbed. Even in that sense of, disturbed mind, he is not harsh. Moreover, he cannot be harsh to Lakshmana, because after all, Lakshmana is one who has forsaken the, pleasures of that city life. He has come along with him to forest life. He has come along with Rama to serve Rama. So, after all, he is like that. And prana samaha, he is equal to his own prana. So, he cannot hurt Lakshmana. So, why this thing has done? Suppose I myself do something wrong. And how do I punish myself? I only feel bad. So, Rama is only feeling like that for Lakshmana. If it is somebody else, I may shout at him. But if I myself do some mistake, how do I feel? I feel very, very bad. So, Rama is feeling like that. So, he catches hold of his hand and then madhurodarkam idam parusham artavat. Sweet outward, sweet tone, but harsh in message. Why did you come like this? Aho Lakshmana. garhyam te kritam, what a bad thing you have done. So that is what he said. And so he now says, he also guesses what could have happened. I have no doubt that Sita must have been eaten away. Sita must have been eaten away or taken away by somebody. And asamshayam Lakshmana nasti Sita. I have no doubt, Lakshmana, Sita is no more. Hata hruta mrutava pativartateva. Hruta means say she has been abducted. Haranam means abduction. Hruta means somebody who is abducted. Hrutava, mrutava, either she has been killed or pativartateva, or somewhere she is wandering somewhere, she is captured somewhere. So that is what she says. And we now come to the next sarga, that is 58th sarga, where Rama is again say putting all type of different questions, you see, different questions. And in fact, not only questions, he is they are still on the way. Rama and Lakshmana are still on the way to Parnashala, and that is quite far, because they have been drawn far away from that say Parnashala. And en route, Rama's anxiety, in that anxiety he is talking so many things. We'll let us see what he talks. So he says, will Sita be safe at all? And she has been a friend in friend of me in all distress. Rajya Bhrashtasya Dinasya Dandakan Paridhavatah. Rajya Bhrashta, I am a Rajya Bhrashta, that is somebody who has been dislodged from the kingdom. And Dina, somebody who is very pitiful. Dandakan Paridhavatah, somebody who has come away to spend time, to spend that forest life in Dandakaranya. So for such a person, Kvasa Dukkha Sahaya, in this Dukkham, in this moment of sorrow, she is my friend. Because a friend is a good friend if he is say continuing to be a friend in times of sorrow. A friend in need is a friend indeed. So a friend who is standing by you in times of sorrow, that is the real friend. That is what he says, Dukkha Sahaya. At the time of sorrow, she is my Sahaya. Sahaya in Sanskrit means a friend. And he also says Prana Sahaya. She is like a friend, and not only my friend, she is my very life. And if something happens to Sita, I am not going to leave. And she is wondering, Kachit Pravrajanam Veera Name Mithya Bhavishyati. After all, I have come all the way to forest. I think all my Vanavasa is going to be a waste, because I thought I have come to Vanavasa, and after this 14 years of Vanavasa, I am going back, and then I am going back to Ayodhya, and I will be there living happily with Sita. With that hope, I am here. And if something has happened to Sita, all my Vanavasa is going to be a waste. And probably this is what is going to give happiness to Kaikeyi. Kaikeyi is very happy. Kaikeyi will be very happy, because if Sita is not there by any chance, I am going to die and you alone will return to Ayodhya. And that is a very happy situation for Kaika. So that is how he is just visualizing, because so many thoughts are coming into Rama's mind. We just see how a host of thoughts, they come to Rama's mind at this time, because he is highly disturbed, because he realizes that Sita has she is alone, Lakshmana has come away. Lakshmana has not yet told why he has come out. He is going to say in the next episode, next sarga. That is, Lakshmana also, he is allowing Rama to give vent to his anger and frustration. Rama is immediately, he is highly disturbed. Lakshmana is just allowing Rama to give some let out, to give vent to his feelings, so that he becomes cool again. So that is what we see in Lakshmana. So here Rama is still saying, if Sita is not found in the ashrama, I am not going to leave. Oh, tell me, Lakshmana, is she alive? So repeatedly asking, oh, is she alive, is she alive? Lakshmana also doesn't know, how can he answer? But still Rama is asking. So it only shows how Rama is in such an anxious state. And Rama says, I guess that when this Maricha fellow cried out, Ha Sita, Ha Lakshmana, you seem to have been driven by her, you seem to have been forcibly sent by her, otherwise you would not have come. And that is how, talking like that, they reach the ashrama, and the ashrama is empty. And when the ashrama is empty, then Rama immediately collapses. He says, Yetad yetad tad ityeva nivasa bhumav. Yetad tad, that is, what I thought has come true. whatever I thought has come true, and he wails now. And we come to the next sarga, where again Rama and Lakshmana, they are again talking. In this sarga, of course, Lakshmana is going to say under what circumstances he left Sita and came away. So, Rama here in this sarga, that is 59th sarga, he is asking, why did you leave? I trusted you. I trusted you and left that place. Why did you leave that place? So, the moment I saw you, I suspected that there is something wrong. And now Lakshmana, he is now replying. Because Lakshmana gave him some time, gave Rama some time to give vent to his frustration, give vent to his anger and all that feelings. Now he is replying. See, I did not come out willingly. I was actually forced to come out because of her very, very strong words. And this, when the Rakshasa imitated your voice, then he repeats what all happened, how Sita, started suspecting him, how Sita said, you want to have me as your wife, and you are Bharata's agent and what not, and you are the Prachannachari, you are the enemy in disguise, and because of all that, I was so pained, and that is the reason why I came away. So, Lakshmana also is temporarily overtaken by anger. So, Lakshmana, when Sita shouted at him rather, or made all types of accusations, wrong accusations, Lakshmana indeed he felt very, very pained, and he felt very anger, felt very, very angry also. And with that anger, he has come out. Now, Rama is saying, you could have tolerated. After all, he says, Nahite paritushyami tyaktva yadasi maithilim. I am not very happy that you have come out. Nahite paritushyami. I am not happy that you have come out. Kruddhayaha parusham srutva striya yatvamihagataha. She is number one, she is angry. And number two, she is a woman. A woman, when she is angry, she may use certain words. She may say something very, very harsh, something which is very intolerable also at times. But you have to tolerate. This is a normal principle for everyone. When women shout, the wisest thing is just to tolerate. We may not be at the level of Socrates. Socrates' wife Xanthippe was known to be a very, very harsh lady, and Socrates was such a accommodating husband. Even if something is broken on his head, he used to take it very, very coolly. So that was Socrates. So if not at that level, we have to be slightly cool. Rama says like that, even if women talk rather harshly, we should not immediately react with anger. You could have tolerated, you could have waited. Krodhasya vashamagamya, na karo shasanam mama. You have temporarily been swayed by anger, you have been overpowered by anger. Unfortunately, that is a very bad thing. So, that is what he says. And now, they look everywhere in that ashrama. She is not found, and now they have to look around in that forest. How they look around, how Rama wails and all that. Rama continues to lament in the next few sargas. Rama's lamentation, how much he loves Sita. You see, there are two aspects of Rama. Number one, Rama is a very, very devoted husband. He loves Sita so much. And we can contrast this to Rama's behavior at the end of Yuddhakanda, where Sita self-imposes that sort of Agni Pariksha. It is not something which Rama imposes, it is a sort of self-imposed Agni Pariksha. At that time, Rama is very mutely watching. So, you can see this behavior, because Rama, when he is the custodian of Dharma, as a custodian of Dharma, he has to uphold Dharma. But as a husband, how devoted he is. How so much of love he has to his wife. All that we will see in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.